ego. To exercise dominion. If there is no hunger, will there be need for cooking? If you are not hungry, will you need food? So hunger is the problem, isn't it? Preparing food is the solution. It means that hunger is an opportunity for somebody to cook, isn't it? So are the problems of your life. There are vehicles that helps you to exercise your authority as a king who was created to reign. Until your mindset begins to change about you. Write this down. Until your mindset begins to change about you. Until your mindset begins to change about you, nothing changes around you. Until your mindset begins to change about you, nothing changes around you. Until your mindset begins to change about you, nothing changes around you. Hallelujah.
You understand?
Until your mindset about you begins to change, until you begin to look at it from another paradigm shift, until you begin to understand that I'm not a loner, until you begin to understand I'm not a failure and I cannot be a failure, until you begin to understand I am complete and perfect, until you begin to understand I am able to accomplish my purpose, nothing changes around you. Everything remains the same. So the shift you need is in your mind. Hallelujah. The shift you need is in where? Is in your? The shift you need is in your mind. Hallelujah. If God is blessing you, wave your hand to Jesus. The challenges around you are actually the fuel that are designed to push you into a life of dominion. Have you seen? The challenges around you, they are what? They are the fuel that has been designed to push you. The last 3 to 4 weeks I've been telling you, no pain, no gain. No sacrifice, no blessings. So concerning every aspect of your life, you need a new mindset of dominion. That marriage that was rocky or is rocky, begin to change your opinion about it. Because as a man thinking in his, so is he. Hallelujah. Sometimes we are the demons that build devil ourselves. You understand? By the kind of imagination. You know, somebody just wake up and create trouble from nowhere. You understand? And then bring the trouble everywhere. Praise the name of the Lord. The people who are insecure in their relationships, apart from the fact that some people are perennial cheats, you understand? Irredeemable cheats, yeah? You know? God have mercy on them. You understand? There are also people who don't understand the value of thinking right. Praise the name of the Lord. They don't understand the value. Many people don't know that when you take time to think right, it brings peace. It brings peace and tranquility your way. Praise the name of the Lord. Some people are perpetual askaris. Watch night. That is the right word. Watch night. They don't have peace because everybody is always against them. You understand? It's in their mind. It's in their minds. Praise the name of the Lord. Your challenges were designed to stretch you. Have you seen? Your challenges were designed to stretch you till you realize what you are created for and go for it. Hallelujah. Your challenges were designed. Jerome, I expect you to be writing, not looking. Your challenges were designed. Amen. Your challenges were designed to stretch you till you realize what you were created for and go for it. Hallelujah. The challenges that Jesus went through pushed him to Gethsemane, isn't it? Until he realized that it is the will of God for him to go to the cross. He never went for it. Hallelujah. When you realize what it is yours, no one will stop you from claiming it. Every problem that shows up in your life, listen to this carefully. And I want you to say this after me. Every problem that shows up in my life, I have the capacity to deal with and profit from. Every problem that shows up in my life, I have the capacity to deal with and profit from. Have you seen? Every problem that shows up in your life, you have the capacity to deal with them and profit from them. Every problem that comes your way, God knows you are able to handle. None is tempted beyond that which they are able to bear, says the Bible. Hallelujah. You understand? God knows you are able. And the problem is, you focus on the problem other than the purpose of the problem. Mindsets, perspectives, shift. Hallelujah. Problems are overwhelming you. You know why? You have a mindset of a victim. Change that today. Because you are not a victim. I told you biologically, you are a conqueror, isn't it? Biologically. And if you do research, pregnancy is prone to complications. Particularly when a woman has conceived and she's not aware of the baby in. Sometimes she misuses herself, too much rigors, you know. She eats things that are not pleasant. She's not even aware she's pregnant. And yet, you were not aborted. Now, if you were not aborted in your mother's womb, then nothing will abort your vision on earth. I say it again. If you were not aborted in your mother's womb, then nothing will abort your vision on earth. Amen. In the name of Jesus. Amen. Are you with me? You are not a victim, my friend. You are a man of dominion, a woman of dominion. Once your mindset about you changes to that of dominion, you will see your problems differently. Hallelujah. When people throw jabs at me, I see an opportunity for somebody to learn there's an anointing somewhere. So it is in your interest to be my friend. You want to try if I'm lying. Try to be my enemy for a while. Hallelujah. Praise the name of the Lord. I always remember this with a lot of sadness. A woman of God, the Lord sent me to in 2014. I told her what God told me concerning her marriage and what she should do. She branded me a devil worshiper. Because she had a platform and I don't have it. And I said to myself, if the spirit in me and that in you is striving at each other, then I'm afraid what is in you. Today she's on the street. I'm not proud of the fact that she's on the street, but that is what happened to people. You understand? Who don't value the anointing? You understand? Sometimes people hurt you. They will pay for that, but you will also pay for the door you open for them to hurt you. You understand? Yes, God will punish the one who hurt you. You will also pay for your own mistake for granting them audience. You get the point? So we should be careful what we do. And each one of you seated here, you are the anointed of God. You are what? When the Bible says, touch not my anointed and do my prophet no harm. He was not talking to prophet. He was talking to you. Hallelujah. You understand? That is who you are. God anointed. You are cherished by the Lord. Amen. You are not defined by those things around you. You are defined by the one you are connected with. Your maker. Your life is hid in Christ with God. Far above principalities and powers. Say, I am far above. Say, I am far above. Amen. When your mindset of dominion is in place, you will see problems differently. You will see them as opportunities and not limitations. Shakespeare said, and I quote, sweet are the uses of adversity. Now you understand it better. Sweet are the uses of adversity. Instead of crying and sitting dejected and hopeless in the face of adversity, you will arise and take charge of what is yours. Instead of doing what? Crying and sitting dejected and hopeless in the face of adversity, you will arise, invoke your covenant authority of dominion, and counter the lies of the devil. Praise the name of the Lord. Amen. Understand you are more than a
and conquer. Hallelujah.
You must create an enabling environment for your mind to process your dominion heritage. You must do what? Create an enabling environment. And that environment is created via information. Created by what?
By information.
I've told you, learn how to read. Read the Bible. Read book. How a woman gets pregnant. And I saw those who are like you. How did they navigate that journey? Hallelujah. How do you develop the dominion mindset? I'll give you three. I'll give you the other four next week. And then we continue with the message of next week. President of the Lord, how do you develop dominion mindset? How do you develop it? Number one, you must have the knowledge of your purpose. And when you write knowledge, underline the word knowledge, underline the word purpose. Hallelujah. Praise Jesus. Praise Jesus.
Amen.
Praise Jesus.
Amen.
You must have the knowledge of your purpose. Underline the word knowledge. Underline the word purpose. You know that knowledge comes via information, right? So you must have the knowledge of your purpose. Now, knowing your purpose puts you on the path to dominion. You understand? When you know you are created to fulfill something, you have what it takes to do it, isn't it? Because you know the path you are traveling through. Hallelujah. And in which area of life do you need dominion? Every square of life you need dominion. Hallelujah. In your finances, in your marriage, in your academic, in your profession, in your career, in your education, you need dominion in every area of life. Praise the Lord. And you know the knowledge of your purpose gives you something to live for. The knowledge of your purpose gives you something to live for. The knowledge of your purpose gives you something to live for. Number two, you must know your potential in God. You must know what? You must know your potential in God. What gifts do you possess that can enhance your purpose? You must know your potential in God. What gifts do you possess that can enhance your purpose? These are your own research that you need to carry out to walk in dominion. Number three, you must have the knowledge of your resources. You must have the knowledge of what? Yeah, this is very important. You must have the knowledge of your resources. This means knowing the opportunities that are available unto you as one who is connected with God. You see? Knowing the opportunities that are available unto you as one that is connected with God. That is your resources. The Bible in Philippians 4:13 says, I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. That's your resources. It means you are unstoppable. If you can put your mind to it, then your hand can accomplish it. Hallelujah. I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. You can break the cycle of poverty. You can break the cycle of disappointment. You can break the cycle of loneliness. You can break the cycle of sickness. You can break the cycle of disappointment. Whatever you want to change, you are capable of breaking that change. Because you have Christ. Christ in you, the hope of
glory.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And finally today, you must have the knowledge of your source. You must have the knowledge of your source. And where is your source? Your source is from God. I will lift up my eyes unto the hills. From where cometh my help? My aid cometh from above. Hallelujah. You must be aware of your source. You must know who has called you to run that purpose. God. You must know He who has empowered you for dominion. You must understand, what can God do? You are able, great and mighty God. You are able, Jesus. You understand? He's able to do all things.
Hallelujah.
It's the one who has empowered you. It's your source. What does God have? Heaven and earth belong to Him. All the resources are His. So you cannot live in want. The Lord is my shepherd. I shall not. Hallelujah. What has God accomplished before? He has raised the dead. Healed the blind. Healed the sick, isn't it? He has parted the oceans. So what is impossible with God? So can your case be possible with Him? So those are the things you need to begin to wire your mind for dominion thinking. Hallelujah. You know the Bible says, He's more than capable to do what He says He will do in your life, isn't it? Huh? I can do all things through Christ, right? Who strengthens me? I am praying for you that the Lord will give you a shift in your mindset today. And this week you will walk in dominion in the name of Jesus. Let us rise up to pray.
Welcome, Lord, we welcome you.